Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sipaha. This is the second part of my series, Important Provisions of POCSO Act. In my first part, I have explained the objective of the Act, some of the important duties of police officer, then some of the offences and punishment related to it. In this part, I'm going to explain the reporting of the offence, recording of the statement, obligation and duties of media, and medical examination. So let's start. First is reporting of offences. As you all know that this is a gender neutral act. That means it is not only for a female child but also for a male child. So any person who is having a knowledge that such type of child abuse is going on in any family or any colony or any institution, it is mandatory for that person that he should report that abuse. No matter that person is child himself or any other child. He may be his brother, sister, friend, anyone. Anyone who is having a knowledge or even an apprehension that such type of activity, that means child abuse is going on or it may happen in the future, then it is his duty to report that crime. And if any person fails to do so, then he may be punished for the term of 6 months or he may be punished with a fine or both. So that's why it is a duty and it is mandatory for any person who is having an idea of a commission of child abuse anywhere or having an apprehension that such type of activity may happen anywhere, then it is duty. Secondly, if any person who is in charge of any institution or a company and his subordinate is engaged in such type of child abuse, then again it is duty of that in charge to report that crime. This may happen in any school, in any hostel, remand home, then juvenile home, special home, orphanage, anywhere. So if a person who is in charge of that particular place, company or institution, it is his duty to report the crime against the subordinate. And if he fails to do so, then there will be a punishment for 1 year and fine or both. So it is a duty of every person, every citizen, that if they know about the child abuse or any sexual abuse on any child, or if they are having an apprehension of that act, then they should first report either to the special juvenile police unit or the local police. Further, in reporting of offences, where the report is given by the child, the same shall be recorded in the simple language so that that child could understand the content of that report. And if by any chance child fails to understand the whole content or he is having a language problem or some part of that report, then any translator or interpreter can be called to make him understand in a simple language the whole content of the report. Thereafter, once the report has been made, then afterwards the police, if they think that a child is in need of care and protection, then they may send that child either to the shelter home or to the hospital, whatever the case it may be. And then afterwards, that should be done within the 24 hours. And afterwards, the report of such offense and the police officer has sent that child to the need of care and protection, wherever they have sent that child, must be reported within 24 hours to the Child Welfare Committee and also to the Special Court. And if in that place there is no Special Court, then it should be reported to the Court of Session. So this is the process of reporting of offence. Next is punishment for the false complaint or false information, because these things are very common these days. Any person who makes false complaint or information against any person with an intention to humiliate, extort, threaten, or defame him then he shall be punished for 6 months or fine or both. Secondly, if child himself do this type of thing, that means a false information or false complaint, then there is no punishment for the child. Third one, whoever, not being a child, makes a false complaint or provide false information against a child, knowing it be a false, thereby victimizing such child in any of the offense under this act, he shall be punished for 1 year or with fine or both. Now, in these type of activity or these type of child abuse, there are certain obligations also of media, studio, photographic facilities. These are to report cases. Now, how? Any person of the media or hotel or lodge or hospital or club or studio or photographic facilities by whatever name called, irrespective of the number of person employed there, shall on coming across any material or object which is sexually exploitative of the child, including pornographic, sexual related, or making obscene representation of a child or children, through the use of any medium, they shall provide such information to the SDPU or local police, as the case may be, because they are aware of such type of activity. So it is their duty to report the crime. There are some procedures for media also in this act. First, no person shall make any report or present comments on any child from any form of media or studio or photographic facilities without having complete and authentic information, which may have effect of lowering his reputation or infringe upon his privacy. Secondly, no report in media shall disclose the identity of child, which includes name, address, photographs, family details, schools, neighborhood, or any other particulars which may lead to disclosure of identity of the child. This is very important that media should not disclose the identity of child in any way, provided that the competent court or a special court has permitted such disclosure. In its opinion, such disclosure is in the interest of the child. Then only the disclosure can be done by the media. Thirdly, the publisher or owner of the media or studio or photographic facility shall be jointly and severely liable for the acts and omission of his employee if there is any disclosure of such report. And if anyone is violating such duties and such procedure of the act, then they are punished with the imprisonment of minimum of 6 months and maximum of 1 year, or with fine or both. Next is recording of the statement. Now, this is something which has to be taken into consideration, because whenever this sort of abuse, a child abuse has been committed, that to a sexual abuse has been committed on any child, that child must be in trauma or in a fear. So that should be handled with care. And this is a child-friendly act, and they understand this type of trauma. That's why it has been mentioned in the act that the recording of the statement must be done in the residence of the child or any other place of his or her choice, preferably by the woman police officer, that to not belong the rank of sub-inspector. Secondly, no child should be detained in the police station in the night for any reason. Thirdly, police officer should not be in the uniform, that too may create a trauma or fear in child. Then the police officer making the investigation shall, while examining the child, ensure that no point of time the child come in the contact in any way with the accused. Then the police officer shall ensure that the identity of the child is protected from the public media unless otherwise directed by the special court in the interest of the child. There are some additional provisions regarding the statement to be recorded. The magistrate or the police officer, whatever the case it may be, they may record the statement of the child in the presence of his parent or any other person in whom the child has trust or confidence. Thereafter, as the case may be, the assistant, if it is needed, then they may call the translator or the interpreter to make the child comfortable. Then thereafter, as the case may be, if the child is mentally or physically disabled, it may happen that the child is mentally or physically disabled. In that particular stage, the police or magistrate may seek the assistance of a special educator or any person familiar with the manner of communication of the child or an expert of that field having such qualification or experience. They may call them to understand and record the statement of the child. And whenever possible, as the case may be, they must ensure, that means the police or the magistrate, that the statement of the child must be recorded by audio, visual, electronic medium. Next is medical examination of a child. Again, if child is sexually abused, then it is necessary to have a medical examination, and it must be conducted in the presence of the parents or any other person on whom the child has trust or confidence. And if the case is of a girl child, then the medical examination shall be conducted by a woman doctor. So this is the end of my series of some of the important provisions of POCSO Act, and in which I have discussed reporting of offense, recording of statement, obligation and procedure of media, and medical examination to be conducted on child abuse. And this is very short and precise video. For the detailed notes, you may visit to my website, and you may also follow me on other social media, which I have already mentioned. And if you like the video, please do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye bye.